friend once taught me the prayer of three breaths. Before we begin the story, let's each take three breaths to become still and ready. This is a Quaker story about some of the different ways that we listen. God is always close as breath. But sometimes, unless we stop and are still and listen, we may not know God's presence there. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. We listen with our ears and with our hearts, our minds, our imaginations. And sometimes God speaks to us in a place deep within. Some friends speak about an inner light, a place within us where God is at home with us and we are at home with God. Other friends speak of this as spirit. Whatever words you use, Spirit comes close, and when we listen, it helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. Sometimes, that of God in one person seems to speak to that of God in another. Heart touches heart. And this might be because of love or friendship, but also in times of conflict between us. God is there too. We practice listening, and Spirit helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. And sometimes it's through the gifts of nature, the great gifts of creation, and how we know them, perhaps with our senses, that we feel Spirit come close to us. We use our ears. We might use our eyes. Our noses. Our tongues and our taste. perhaps our skin, our sense of touch. For some of us, these gifts of creation, coming close to them in the world, is when we feel close to Spirit. And Spirit helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. And sometimes it is through stories that we come close to God's presence. These might be the stories of any people, of any faith, in any time, who have listened in holy obedience for how to love, what to do, and who to be. They might be the stories of the ancient Hebrew people. Many of those stories happen in the desert. A place where they came close to God and God came close to them, where there were many journeys. They might be the stories, like the parables that Jesus told, that are like a gift that we are given. A gift you were given before you were even born. They may be the stories that are songs and poems, where the words speak to something within us and touch our hearts, and through their beauty or how they challenge us, we listen and know the presence of Spirit, and it helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. And sometimes it is when we gather. When we come together to worship, when we come together to witness, when we come together for service, sometimes this is when we know God's presence in a new and different way. God is within us and between us, all around us. Sometimes when we gather, it is like we're being held. Sometimes we talk about a covered meeting. And we say, "Here we are, God. We will be your people. We will be listening ears, speakers of truth, hands in service, feet to march on on journeys. We will lift up our voices in love and for justice and peace. The Spirit helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. We practice listening. We listen with our whole selves. I don't know what goes here for you. What other places and times and ways you listen. And feel the presence of Spirit in all the ways we might listen. We listen with our whole selves. We listen with our ears and our minds and with our hearts, our imaginations, with the light within. And Spirit helps us to know how to love, what to do, and who to be. I wonder, as we settle into waiting worship, I wonder what part of the story you liked best. I wonder if there are other ways. What other ways you have felt God's presence? I wonder what helps you listen for God. I wonder what you wonder about this.